This week at Interior, striking the right balance with energy development and conservation and tackling climate change, among the topics addressed this week as Secretary Jewell offered her vision for a safe, secure, and prosperous future of American energy. In remarks at the Center for Strategic and International Studies, the Secretary pointed to a huge shift in the energy landscape over the last several years and what it's all meant for the average American family.
Since 2008, American oil production has surged from 5 million to 9 million barrels a day. And our dependence on foreign oil has fallen to its lowest level in more than 30 years. The amount of solar energy has increased tenfold, and wind energy has tripled since 2008. That's been helped by more than $340 billion of private sector investment and a tax policy that helped move these investments off the sidelines. Families are driving farther than ever on a tank of gas. And with lower gas prices, the average household will have an extra $750 in their pockets in 2015.
The Secretary said the U.S. needs to be the world leader on safe energy development, enacting effective reforms that encourage innovation and protect America's public lands and waters for future generations.
It's pretty simple. If we don't have the right measures in place to protect the communities we live in, the air we breathe, and the water we drink, we all lose.
The Secretary also talked about Interior's role in transitioning to a low-carbon future.
So for us at Interior, we're already adjusting our land management strategies for the impacts of climate change. But we also need to do more, and we can, to address the causes of climate change. Helping our nation cut carbon pollution should inform our decisions about where we develop, how we develop, and what we develop.
She also cited the sweeping safety reforms that Interior has put in place in the wake of the Deepwater Horizon tragedy nearly 5 years ago.
We've raised the bar through new standards for well design, production systems, blowout prevention, and well control equipment. And we've overhauled federal oversight by restructuring ourselves to provide independent regulatory agencies that have clear missions and are better resourced to carry out their work.
The Secretary then traveled to New Orleans, where she opened an oil and gas lease sale this week that offered more than 41 million acres in the central planning area of the Gulf of Mexico. The sale brought in $539 million in high bids. The Secretary says the Gulf remains a critical component of our nation's energy portfolio. And the USGS, among the international partners in the release this week of a new international report called Frozen Heat, a global look on methane gas hydrates. Methane is among the greenhouse gases that contribute to climate change, as well as an important energy source. This report examines the methane frozen beneath the ocean floor. USGS scientists have studied methane deposits all over the world, from Alaska to the Gulf of Mexico, and from India, Korea, and Japan. Find out more at usgs.gov. That's this week at Interior.